Have you ever wondered what it would be like to soar high above California? Imagine looking down and seeing deep canyons pass by. Mountains gilded in the warm light of sunset. A sparkling silver ocean that slowly comes into view. Or a town filled with life and laughter just below. This is one of the rarest views in the world as seen through the eyes of one of the rarest creatures, the California condor. And there is great hope for its future on the horizon.
Here we're surrounded by natural habitats.
More California condors live in Ventura County than anywhere else. And most of these students didn't even know they had condors or what a condor was.
We have read about the condors, we've researched, but until we see it, it's not going any deeper than that. So that's what I'm excited and I look forward to, is to just see that excitement on their face, seeing something for the very first time.
We bring the stories of these animals in their habitats to our visitors. That way, they can learn how they too can become advocates for these species.
Oh. It's very hands-on, very interactive. It's exciting. We're not spending all our time just reading a book or just writing a paragraph. We're actually interacting and within nature and all these different things.
Who knows what this monstrosity is?
The Condor Kids program and connecting people with nature is extending way beyond the classroom. They're way ahead of the general public on knowledge of condors, and more importantly, conservation in general. Between U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service and the Santa Barbara Zoo.
And then there are two canyons.
We're conservation partners.
The role of zoos has changed. We're also doing work in the field because we feel responsible for these animals. If the condors can't successfully fledge a chick, they don't have a fighting chance. So some of the techniques that are used in the zoos were developed by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, rescuing condors from the wild. Whether it's zoo camp, condor kids, the education side is critical.
There's some right here.
Creating the passion is easy in kids.
Yep, look like maybe coyote.
They want to be passionate. They want to enjoy school. They want to enjoy life. And I think the teacher needs to have the passion too. You need someone who's going to take that passion, and we want to make sure that they are passionate about things that are positive and help our environment.
When I have the opportunity to work with children who live right there with the condors and see their enthusiasm, it just, my heart swells.